but knowing that you have a pre-existing condition makes you feel a little bit threatened, because there is a fear among folks who have pre-existing conditions that politicians will intercede where they ought not between a doctor and a patient, and worse still, perhaps even take away their ability to pay for their own care, either sentence them to a lifetime of fundraisers, or worse still, make sure that they don't have access to that care.
Now, you're going after Tony Evers in the ad, who is also a cancer survivor. He said in a statement that he respects your strength and bravery, but in quote, doesn't change the fact that the Walker administration spent the last 8 years trying to undermine the Affordable Care Act and gut protections for millions of Wisconsinites. It was just, I believe, in January where he introduced this measure.
But the fact of the matter, Emily, is we don't need Obamacare to cover pre-existing conditions. In fact, the governor's bill, the one that was passed by the assembly, says we will assure that pre-existing conditions are covered here in the state of Wisconsin, whether there's Obamacare here or not.
Why should the governor have credibility on this issue if he supports fellow Republican Attorney General Brad Schimmel and his lawsuit to eliminate parts of Obamacare? And you were talking earlier about calling legislation. Do we have a timeline if the governor wants to call back lawmakers to address this?
Before, in Wisconsin, before Obamacare, people with pre-existing conditions were covered in a pool we called HERPS. It was an acronym for some high-risk folks who got together who had lower rates than they would have found on the individual marketplace. We could return to that, or as the governor has asserted in the past, we could assure that everyone who wants to do business here in Wisconsin as an insurance provider is required by law to cover people with pre-existing conditions, and that that can't factor into how much they are charged. So those are the pieces of the bill that was already passed by the assembly. That's not the part of Obamacare that is actually dangerous to people like me with pre-existing conditions. There are a whole bunch of additional things that lead to longer wait times, as we have all seen, higher premium costs, and some of the things that they are experiencing in other countries where you have a more socialized medicine system. The government just doesn't belong in the private sector like that.